Just trying to make some out of nothing. Just another day of hustling. Just another day of hustling. Another day of hustling. If it's out there, I'ma go get it. That's why I'm in the field trying to stack me up a million.
Hustlers, hustlers, hustlers. What's cracking? It's your boy Deshaun. Welcome back to another episode of Roof Hustlers, baby. We will tackle all your daily dough-to-dough objections, rejections, and we teach you guys how to make connections, man. Because if you ain't creating genuine customer connections, building better customer relationships, and providing premier customer service, then you know, like I know, guys, you ain't making a difference in your wallet or the community, baby. And that's what we do over here at Roof Hustlers, man. Help you guys go from average to good, from good to great. Always keeping food on your plate, baby. Because if you do what I do, you know it's a jungle out here. Well, this week on Roof Hustlers, what I want to tackle with you guys is, I believe it's the one thing that you can develop and do that's going to help you close more deals. And I believe it's going to be a surprise to a lot of you guys when I say this, but the one thing that you can do that's going to help you close more deals, guys, is develop your leadership skills. Because in this insurance restoration industry, all we doing is leading homeowners through a process. And as you improve your leadership skills, you will close more deals, guys. And just to keep things very simple, very basic, the leadership skills, all it is the ability to influence someone else. That's all being a leader is, the ability to influence another human being or another individual. And if you know anything about John C. Maxwell, he talks about the five levels of leadership. The first one is a positional leadership. People follow you because of your position. Number two, they follow you because of the relationship that you build with them. Number three, they follow you because of the things that you've done. Number four is when you start building other leaders. And number five, when you got a pinnacle of leaders around you guys. So I don't want to go too much in depth with that today. What I want to cover with you guys today is three things that followers are looking for when it comes to a leader. And then I also want to share with you guys three things as you develop your leadership skills, the things that allow you to do with your homeowners, guys. So without further ado, let's jump into today's episode. Like I said, guys, three things that followers are looking for in a leader, and three things that you develop your leadership skills, it allow you to start doing with your homeowners. Understand, guys, leaders, they inspire us to go places that we would never go otherwise. So when we meet these homeowners, it's our job to inspire them to go to a place that they would have never went on their own. So I want you to be mindful of that, guys. Ronald Reagan once said, leaders aren't necessarily the people that do great things. They are the people that help the people do the greatest things. So with that being said, the first thing that followers are looking for in the leader is the ability to empower and motivate them. So understand that, guys, when we meet homeowners, our job isn't to persuade them or use all these sales tips and tricks to, you know, get them to sign paperwork. Our job is to empower them to solve their problems, motivate them to take some action to take care of their property. So that's one of the first things that followers are looking for in a good leader, guys. Empower your homeowner, motivate your homeowner, inspire your homeowner to take some action, guys. So that's the first thing that homeowners are looking for, and people in general looking for in a great leader, the ability to empower and motivate. The second thing, guys, that homeowners or followers are looking for in a great leader is the ability to listen. Teddy Roosevelt once said, nothing I say today is going to teach me anything new. So if I want to learn something, I need to listen. So be mindful of that, guys. Followers and homeowners are looking for a good listener. So when you're dealing with your homeowners, spend less time talking, more time listening. Like I said, that's why God gave you two ears and one mouth. If you ask questions, allow your homeowner to give you all the information you need and be a great listener, guys. That's all these homeowners and followers are looking for, somebody that can listen to their problems. That way you can get the right information and you can help them solve their problem, guys. So that's the second thing that followers are looking for in a great leader, a leader that listens, a leader that puts themselves second, put their homeowner or their followers first, and take the time to listen, be interested in their problems and the things that they want to say so you can get the real information to solve their real problem, guys. So number two, be a great listener. The third thing that followers are looking for in a great leader, understand, guys, leadership is not making excuses. It's taking responsibility. So the third thing that followers or homeowners are looking for in a great leader is the ability to take responsibility and ownership. So as you going through this process, guys, you got to take ownership. You got to take responsibility. If anything happened, any hiccups, any mess up with the roof, anything that's dealing with the insurance company, you need to take ownership and take responsibility. It is not your homeowner's problem. It is not your homeowner's issue. You need to take extreme ownership. If you never read that book, you need to check it out, guys, by Jacko Willink, Extreme Ownership. Great book to read. And if you implement those principles, because it's a book on leadership, you implement those principles into your grind, guys, I guarantee you, you will close more deals. So the third thing that followers or homeowners are looking for in a great leader is ownership and responsibility. They want you that if you mess up, you say, that's my fault, I'll fix it. You know, if the install date get pushed back, call your homeowner, let them know. If there's issues dealing with the insurance company, keep them in the loop, take responsibility for that and solve the problem, guys. So that's the third thing that followers or homeowners are looking for in a great leader, the ability to take ownership and responsibility of this process. So quick week recap, guys, three things that followers or homeowners looking for in a great leader. The first one, the ability to empower and motivate the homeowner or your followers in general. Number two, the ability to be a great listener. Spend more time listening than you do talking, guys. And number three, take ownership and responsibility of this process as a whole. That way your homeowner can feel at ease and understand that they got a great leader taking them through this process and they have nothing to worry about. So those are the three things that followers or homeowners are looking for in a great leader. And if you could just implement those three things, that can help you close more deals, guys. So we're gonna take it a step further. I'm gonna give you three things that as you develop your leadership skills, what it's gonna allow you to do. The first thing, as you develop your leadership skills, that it's gonna allow you to do, it's gonna allow you to develop deeper and trusting relationships with your homeowners, guys. Understand that these homeowners are never looking for another salesman, but they're always looking for an expert. They're always looking for a leader. After we get up on the roof and inspect the roof, guys, the next thing that most homeowners ask is, what's happening next? So as you become a better leader, you become more fearless, it's gonna allow you to develop that deeper and trusting relationship with your homeowners. And I'm telling you, humans are always looking for somebody to follow. And if you don't develop your leadership skills, your homeowner will lead you through this process versus you leading them through this process. And then you're gonna have issues getting a check, you're gonna have issues getting the scope of work, you're gonna have all these issues dealing with your homeowners. So as you develop those leadership skills, it's gonna allow you to develop those deeper trusting relationships, and we're not gonna have problems, you know, collecting that first check or getting the scope of work or even just getting access to speak to the insurance company with your homeowner's permission. So that's the first thing that as you develop stronger leadership skills is gonna allow you to do, develop that deeper and trusting relationship with your homeowners. Because as you got a great relationship with your homeowner, they're gonna go tell their friends, it's gonna lead to more referrals. So that's a plus as you develop your leadership skills, your homeowner's gonna, you know, feel more trusted, more invested in dealing with you, and they're gonna tell their friends as well. So that's the first thing, guys, is gonna develop deeper and trusting relationships with your homeowners. The second thing, guys, as you develop and strengthen your leadership skills throughout this process, it's gonna allow you to encourage your homeowners to hang on through tough times. Understand, when things getting rough with the insurance company, and your homeowner feel like it's over and they don't wanna continue forward, these are when your leadership skills need to kick in. They're gonna make your homeowner wanna stick through those tough times with you. Fight to the end of this process. If we got to take it to litigation, they willing to fight with us to the end till we get this roof paid for. But understand, they're only going to want to do this with a guy who got great leadership skills, a guy who is invested into this process with them, and a guy that's leading them through this process, telling them what's going to happen next, telling them, staying in communication, keeping them up to date with everything. You might look at those as simple sales skills. No, guys, those are leadership skills. That's you being a strong leader, communicating with your homeowner, keeping them in the loop. That way, when times get tough, they're looking to their leader to give them a peace of mind, to give them that certainty, to give them that clarity that they made the right decision. And if you as a leader can't deliver that to your homeowner, guys, they're gonna wanna back out. They're gonna step away from this process. So that's the second thing that as you develop good leadership skills, it's gonna allow you to encourage and keep your homeowners invested in this process during the tough times. Because when times get tough, we're looking for a leader. Right now it's election time. We're looking for the right leader, guys. So I'm telling you, when times get rough with your homeowners, they're looking for a leader to make them understand and make them feel like they made the right decision. So as you develop your leadership skills, that's what it's gonna allow you to do. Keep your homeowners plugged into this process, even when times get rough. And the third thing, guys, as you strengthen and develop your leadership skills, what's it going to do for you? It's going to give you the ability to negotiate complex contracts with your homeowners. That way, all sides are satisfied. Understand, negotiation is about both sides walking away with a win. As you improve those leadership skills, you're going to be able to deal with that deductible. That way, both parties are happy. Or deal with the insurance company to where you negotiate a contract price with them, and they're happy with, you know, what they paid out, and you happy with what you receive. But if you just only relying on sales skills, that's not going to be good enough. You're going to have to strengthen those leadership skills, guys, and you got to dive into the leadership books. You need to get around the guys in your company or in the industry that has those strong leadership skills and take as much of those qualities as you can. But when you're a strong leader, that's how you can get the AOB signed. That's how you can get all this tedious paperwork signed, guys. That's how you get, you know, your homeowner to agree to send that O&P paperwork and all those things like that. All it is, it comes from developing strong leadership skills. Like I said earlier, John C. Maxwell, the 5 levels of leadership. You need to get on a level 3 leadership with all of your homeowners, which is they following you because of what you've done. So as you got a history of success with other homeowners, you need to share those stories with your new homeowners. That strengthens your leadership skills and allow you to negotiate those complex contracts so all sides are happy. Everybody will feel like they won. And in reality, we did win. You know, we probably got the upper hand, but all sides feeling satisfied. And that comes from developing strong leadership skills, guys. So I highly encourage that you take the time to invest into your leadership skills. Most people think leadership is only comes when you got a team full of people or, you know, you're leading your family and all these things. No. Your homeowners need you to be a good leader. And as you improve your leadership skills, the whole grind, getting paperwork signed, collecting checks, all that things becomes a lot simpler, guys. Quick recap, guys. As you develop and strengthen your leadership skills, the first thing it's gonna allow you to do is develop deeper and trusting relationships with your homeowners, which is super important, guys. Second thing it's gonna allow you to do, encourage your homeowners to stick through when times get tough. When these insurance processes start to get rough, they're looking for a leader to give them the right direction to go. And the third thing it's gonna do for you guys, allow you to negotiate complex contracts so all sides are happy. Because that's the goal in this process, to have win-win relationships, interpersonal relationships. That way your homeowner happy and you happy, guys. So that's what I believe the one thing that you can do to improve your sales process and your close, the amount of deals that you close, is improving your leadership skills. And as you do that, guys, I guarantee you this process is gonna get a lot simpler. It'll never get easy, you just get better. And as you develop those leadership skills, you're gonna close more deals, you're gonna help more people, and you're gonna be able to be an asset to your company, guys. So if you like what you heard today, please leave us comments down in the comment box. We do pay attention to those. Shoot us an email over at roofhustlers@gmail.com if there's any topics that you want us to cover. Make sure you follow us on Instagram at roofhustlers, on Facebook, Deshaun Bryant. Please, like I said, leave comments, you know, DM me. I love to communicate with the community. And if you haven't already yet, guys, please shoot me an email. Get you a free copy of The Hustler's Guide to Dough-to-Dough. It's success principles that's going to help you be successful in the field, because behind every principle is a promise. Behind your feelings are nothing. So if you're still hustling with your feelings, guys, you definitely need The Hustler's Guide to Dough-to-Dough so you can implement some principles in your grind. So as always, baby, hustle hard, hustle smart, and don't be afraid to bogart. Hustlers, I'm out. Just another day of hustling.